Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to ARK Survival Evolved with me, Laughtrix, and welcome to the setting screen. Like I said before, if I ever do change any of the settings, I will make sure that you know exactly what I've changed, so that I'm as transparent as possible. Now, in the last episode, I was speaking about increasing the harvest amount, so that I may speed up my progress in terms of honestly, mostly just making my own ammo and such, so that time off camera can be spent more lucratively, like building the structures and such, as I've kind of slowed down a bit now, as the game really is, well, particularly the late game, revolves more around multiplayer than single player, although I still believe that it does give a quite decent single player experience from what I've experienced so far. So, with your overwhelming kind of blessing, Sir and Threat, a lot of you did indeed agree with this. I am going to be altering the harvest amount. Now, I could go to 3 times, and that is very tempting, honestly. It's very tempting indeed. However, I'm going to be a little bit shy of that and go for 2. So from now on, we'll be getting around about double the harvest from any mineral, but not 3 times. I feel that's a bit too fast and might even start to kind of decrease my enjoyment. Now, harvest health, I believe, is the health of the things you harvest, how many times you can hit it, in addition to how much health it has, and I kind of want to see what that actually does. Now, it doesn't change the number, annoyingly, because it's not changed yet. Some things are like that, which is a little bit weird, it must be said, but, do these increase and decrease? Well, isn't it weird, some just don't have the numbers change. I'm going to do this and see if it does anything, just out of my own curiosity, honestly, and I'll see if I enjoy that as well. So that is pretty much that. I did have to refresh to defaults the other day because it did bug out a little bit, just making sure I've got everything that I want as I want it. Nothing to do with my own health and everything. Okay, fantastic, awesome. Okay then, let's get back into the game. Sadly, it does take a very long time to load. Now, this is a difficulty level, and that's a default difficulty level, and I'm not sure what that actually does, considering we have all the options here, including things like player health recovery, so I don't really know what that'll do, probably just more damage from enemies, not too sure. Anyway, be right back in the game. Back home, and now in a shiny suit of armor. Yes, sir and sirettes, I am now beautifully shiny, although my eyebrows are sticking out of my helmet. But yes, I've got some new armor, which I've made off camera, and it's actually ridiculously cheap. However, it does suck when it comes to being a little bit cold. Sorry, it sucks when it's a little bit hot. Basically, the insulation, as you can see with the hypothermic, okay, when it's hot, is actually really, really bad. So this thing will burn you alive in a hot cave or something. But it does provide double the protection of the chitin armor. And it's actually very, very cheap to make, as you can see here. It's only 6 ingots for the gloves and only... Basically, it's metal. It's just metal and a bit of hide. It's very, very cheap to make this stuff, and it's very, very protective. So that's fantastic. I think I have 2 guns left in this lovely pistol of mine. Lovely. Got all the rifle ammo. Excellent. And we will be needing all this today, sir and zrets, because we're going... we're going hunting. And taming. We're going to be hunting a very elusive beast, which honestly, I should have got a bit earlier. And it's a good time to test out our resource gathering. We, sir and zrets, are going hunting for a mammoth. Yes, indeed we are. We are after a mammoth. So what we're going to be doing is putting our little Icarus down here, Angrath there, doing a little bit of a dance. Getting a few more narco berries because, well, actually just berries in general, because I have a lot of narcotics, a lot of other stuff, but I haven't really got many berries, and honestly, you want to use the berries rather than the narcotics when it comes to a herbivore. Thankfully, it seems like I left a hell of a lot on my lovely little pet here. Well done, you, Terra. Get some more, it'd be great. Got any more narcos? Ooh, only 1 stack. That's probably not enough for a mammoth. But yes, so today, so in sense, we're going to be hunting a mammoth for the express purpose of testing out the changes I've just implemented. Don't need all these. Don't need the meat, honestly. We've got so much already everywhere else. Here's the problem as well. I'm taking too many guns and stuff with me. It's quite heavy. So, generally speaking, the purple berries are better. I'm not sure which are the best ones for the mammoth, but we'll find out. Okay, so what I'm going to do is a little bit more harvesting, so I want a few more narco berries. Then we'll go off and find some other stuff. So what I'm going to do is tell my lovely pet here, despite the fact it's got so much wood, just drop everything right now. Yep, drop everything because you're really, really overburdened. There we go, can actually move. Hello there, Parasaur! I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I actually don't know, does the harvest buff actually work with dinosaurs? It's hard to tell because the... Bronto gets so much. Let's just get over to a tree and test that out. Then we'll... Actually, let's just jump off and test it on this little tree here, which is currently getting us stuck. Hello. Give me wood. 3 wood. 16, 19... That's quite a bit from such a small tree. Yeah, that's definitely been increased. I'd say by double, in fact. Excellent. So we do now have double resources when we start collecting. I'm not sure if it's giving me more per swing or it's giving me more overall. I think it's just more overall, which is fantastic. So that's great. So that means as we go now, we can get a lot more metal out of the metal, a lot more obsidian from the obsidian, etc., etc. So that's fantastic. I'm going to say it is increasing my... Yeah, I would say that's more than usual. So I think the Bronto is also being affected by the double harvest. Don't really need it so much, honestly, with the Bronto, but still nice to have it nonetheless. Okay, that'll be enough for now. What can I drop, which is heavy-ish? What can I drop? Oh, there's nothing I can really drop. Everything's... most of it... Okay, let's just put some stuff into the pet. That's what we'll do. Just put that there. My white is... sorry, it's your white. There we go. So we're no longer overburdened. We're a bit slow, but that's fine. We'll be putting all the berries into the mammoth when we find it anyway. So let's go on the Icarus and let's go hunting. See if we can find one. So yeah, the mammoths, as I've kind of half explained, are the ultimate in wood harvesting, although eventually there's going to be like giant beavers and stuff, which is going to be very interesting when they're actually implemented. But for now, the mammoths are apparently the king of harvesting wood, so that's fantastic. So that means I've got the ore and metal harvesting pet, the ankle. We've got the Bronto, which of course is the berry harvesting. And all of my carnivores are the meat harvesting, so the Tyrannosaurus and such. And then we have the hide harvesting in the Sabertooth, which is fantastic. In fact, speaking about Sabertooths, there are several over there, and they're kind of in the way of my mammoths. I don't really want to face them on foot, so what I'm going to do is quickly kill them now with my lovely little Icarus. There we go. Oh my lord. Okay, there we go. There goes one. Wow, it's a lot of damage. They're doing so much damage to me. Okay, don't really want to fight the Argent Ivis there. That can have the meat if it so desires. Look at this one. It's like blue. I choose the blue one. What level are you? I'm actually going to purposely go for a high level. Oh my lord, level 25. Yes. Exactly what I wanted. Okay. This is going to be difficult though, because I've heard these are very difficult to actually knock out. So, thankfully, they are quite slow. So what I need to do is put the Argent Ivis somewhere where it won't automatically aggro. Thankfully, it can defend itself versus pretty much anything, so I'm not too scared. The only thing I'm really scared about it being attacked by is probably a T-Rex. And they're generally quite obvious. They don't generally sneak up on you. So, where am I going to run? Okay, so I'm going to nail it now with a shot. Then I'm going to run up this mountain, try to avoid the other mammoth. Okay. Level 25, this is going to take some serious shooting. Try not to go for the head, because that does more damage to it, which decreases its timing efficiency. Since timing efficiency is based on how much damage it's taken before it gets knocked out, in addition to how much it takes when it is knocked out, so... Just want the arrows to simply hit it anywhere, honestly, like the leg or something. Don't even want bonus damage to be done, so I'm trying to go for its chest. Sadly, its head's kind of huge. I'm a bit slow right now. Probably not a good idea to be so overburdened. There we go, another shot. Okay. Damn, I thought that was it then, but it's just it jumping, weirdly. Well, less jumping, more kind of bugging out over a cliff. Don't really want that Dilo to hit me, because that Dilo will poison me and slow me down. Oh, I got stuck there on a rock. Yes, there you go. Good night, sir. Or, well, madame. Good night, madame. Oof, put the berries in. I'm not sure what its favourite berries are. Oh, poisoned. Okay, now it's okay. Since I'm already done with the... Don't attack the freaking mammoth, please. Oh, I'm almost starving to death. And I'm really, really thirsty. That's great. Okay, where do I put the Argent Ivis? I need to go get some water and basically defend the body. Come on, Icarus. It's like a corpse. Stop being so still. It's creepy. So what will you eat first? I've got basically every kind of berry in there for you, so... Hasn't ate yet. Plus 4 level. Yay. That's going to take a while. And I need to drink. Okay, just land. Oh, I hate birds. I love using them, but I hate them sometimes. I'll wait for it to land then. Then we'll go get some water. Actually, we need to look into how we even make this thing's saddle. I've never made one before. Something tells me it won't be part of the... this. Yeah, Mammoth isn't here. Okay, so Mammoth is part of the smithy recipe then. Okay, Icarus, we've got to be really quick. Let's go get some water and come back. In fact, so what I'm going to do is just skip now. Oh god, there's a freaking saber coming right for him. Okay, kill the saber first. I might have to leave Icarus here and just go by foot. I can't believe I didn't get water before coming here. That's so silly. Come on. There we go. Night-night saber tooth. Yeah, I think I might have to. It's a weird one because it means I'm gone for a longer period of time, but there's actually a defender here, but it's better if I'm the defender, so I don't really... Is there anything that's going to eat the level 25 mammoth I am currently taming in the near vicinity? If no, I'm going to go with the Argent Avis. It looks like I'm okay to go with the Argent Avis, but let's be as quick as possible and even kill that Dilo on the way. Okay. Also, having an Argent Avis makes everything so much easier, I've noticed. I don't know how I lived in this game without having flyers. It's just... they make everything 10 times easier. Being able to travel from place to place safely and quickly is rather nice. I'll give you some proto-elephant little peck on the way. Hopefully it'll attract any predators in the nearby vicinity, and that way I won't have to deal with them myself. Okay, let's get back there. So, combat noises. Why combat noises? Don't attack me. Or did I just get too close to the little Fiomia? Did you just poo? Twice? So that was me and the pet. Well, synchronized pooping. Okay, looks like that was the right choice to do. It's a shame it's... I am so... of the belief that herbivores are much more annoying to tame than carnivores. Just because with a herbivore, first of all, narco berries are better than narcotics because of the taming efficiency, according to the wiki. And that's worse because the narcotics give you more torpor per, you know, narco berry used. Oh my lord, 4,500. Oh. Also, people are now saying on the wiki and such and the forums that you basically tame an animal once it's ate its full food, so it's full food bar here worth of food. This thing has 6,500, but I guess since I've sped it up, it'll be like half of that. This is going to take a while, Sonsrets. This is going to take a while indeed. I may just yeah, what I'll do is I'll do some hunting, try to level up myself and my bird while we wait, and I'll be right back when something interesting happens. So it might be in you're probably going to see now an hour in the future, so be right back. Well, sir and sirettes, there we go. Our own little mammoth. Absolutely fantastic. So, let's have... can't think of a good... right now, I can't think of a great name for it. I was trying to think of one later on. It's a female mammoth, so I will think of something, and it will be absolutely amazing by the end of the episode. But right now, there we go. The mammoth, sir and sirettes, level 29. What? I've reached 25. Okay, I'm going to go and look at the recording. I'm sure you were 25. Oh no, because of my level. It did say level plus 4, didn't it? Oh, because of my level, it leveled up the animal. Oh. That's how it works now. Well, clearly I haven't played since one of the mini patches, considering there's patches every freaking day in this game. Regardless, fantastic. I need to give it a saddle. Almost ate all this food. Yeah, I kind of brought the Bronto over because it was taking so much. But anyway, so this took about an hour and 10 minutes. It's actually ridiculously long considering we have the speed up on. Oh wait, it's already in my inventory. So I decided to start building this because I wanted to mess around with pillars, and it gave me an idea, Sirensreds. You see, pillars can be used as the to support things. I'm not sure exactly how they support certain things, but they do, and I think you can use it to support foundations and such. Which means we could probably make a proper, a... what do you call it? A Bridge! We could try and make a bridge in a second turn, so once we've got the man in the saddle, over the water there, and that's going to be our little goal. I want to make my first ever bridge across water, which means that my land-based animals, particularly the T-Rex, which really, really sucks in water, can actually do something. So yeah, I've made a little base because I got bored, and it's basically a little hunting outpost. I've got a little bed there in case I die nearby. It's kind of cute. Okay, everyone follow me. I will be riding in Icarus so that nothing gets in my way. Let's go. So that's awesome. I didn't actually know you actually get levels up now on the animals you tame. I want to see how much you get then if you tamed, let's say, a level 1. Would it still be plus 4 because of my level, or would it, or is it based off... Oh, look at my little level 29 mammoth. I'm going to level you up so harsh. Come on. Oh, God, the Bronto. The Bronto, Sir and Sirettes. So yeah, that's the plan then. So get back. Check the saddle. I'll be honest, I was going to check the saddle recipe and then completely forgot because I was distracted building my little thing. By the way, even on double resources, that took almost, I'd say about half an hour's worth of resource gathering because, of course, I was actually mostly AFK during this whole experience, as it is just taming an animal. I have enough narco. Okay. Stay there. All I can do is I'll get the Bronto to follow. Oop. No, not you. Go away, I wanted to tame that little guy. There we go. Yeah, you follow Icarus instead. I know you can do that. Come on, follow Icarus. There you go. It's now following Icarus rather than me, which means if I land Icarus somewhere, the Bronto will keep on walking towards Icarus and will not really pay attention to my movements. Okay. I want to see how many more levels you can get from a low-level thing. Normally, parasaurs, I find, are quite low-level. Where did it run to, though? Okay, let's find something that's low level. It's probably stuff on the beach. There's a parasaur. Oh, there's... Choose one of three. Let's find the lowest level of the bunch. Then give it a few berries and see what it's telling me. Nope. Why are you running for... Oh, because the Argentavis hurt it. Must have hurt it, so now it's got the fear of me in it. Level 10. Oh. Probably because the Argentavis is still following me. On the upside, I wanted the Bronto over here. Darn it. Yep, you are stopping. Fantastic. Hopefully it now won't run from me, so level... Ah, there you go, level 3. Click. Flip. And... I don't think it takes more than 3. There we go. Nope, nope, I thought it had gone then. Oh, don't get too close to them, otherwise they'll hit you. Well, night-night. So, let's give you some berries. Just any berries I happen to have in my inventory right now. Which isn't actually much, because I've been eating them. Oh, look, actually, no, I had some in my hotbar. Okay, so now I just need to wait until you're actually eating some food. I'm very curious about that, because that would mean taming level 1s would be both easy and actually not as negative as it used to be, since obviously level 1s are a lot faster to tame. I've just left my mammoth on its own. Got a new animal, instantly leaves it on its own. That's genius. Plus 0. But what? Why did that one get plus 4 then? Okay, I literally don't know how that works. Wow, you tame fast. Well, I guess here we have the bonuses and you're just quick to tame, I suppose. Shall I tame you? I mean, sure, why not? Let's have a parasaur over here. It's not like you're really eating anything when you're inactive anyway. Okay, so you're all now stationary. Let's go back to Icarus and let's get the mammoth saddle sorted. What I'm hoping it'll be is just metal. Well, I'm not hoping it will be is cementing paste or something, because that takes ridiculously long. Also, that bug with the words floating is getting worse every time I log. I think it's based around when I log off and on, which is getting kind of funny, honestly. I also keep forgetting that I brought the scorpion up here, and it keeps really confusing me. Okay, let's see. What do you need? So, saddles. I'm blind. Mammoth saddle requires 140 fiber. Apparently, I've got some in my inventory. It's 30. Do I have any more? Apparently not, unless I'm very much mistaken. So I've got 100 and something there now already. It's fantastic. That's close enough. Then we need 10 metal ingots, which we've got upstairs. So we'll just grab that now. All the metal's currently in the fabricator since I was making the full metal armor suit. So let's take the metal back out. Ooh, fiber! Thank you! Brilliant! That was helpful. Give this to the smithy. So, fiber and metals, and now we'll actually find out if the mammoth is good at harvesting trees. Does it say so in the thing? Because, honestly, I'm just going off what people have told me. Ah, it's a woolly mammoth. Hello. Yeah, can uproot trees without swatting them, okay. So it does say so there. I just realised, like, I hadn't actually read anywhere that that's true. And maybe I've been giving up false information this entire time. Should I just leave Icarus up here? Yeah, I'll just leave Icarus up here, that way I can just... I'll just go down the stairs and get to the mammoth that way and that way. And wait, no, I do want the fly down there. I'll leave it up here. Okay, Miss Mammoth, let's see how good you are at actually getting trees then. Ooh, sharp turning circle. A nice rarity there. Oh, you run so derpily. Aren't you a weird colour? Okay, so this is a tree. Harvest it. Ooh, 11 wood. Wow, you do get... Whoa, that's from... Wait, are you hitting both of these trees? I was going to say, from one of the... Still, though, that's ridiculous. Those two little trees just gave me 88 wood. How did I not have one of these mammoths before? Also, look how fast this thing is. I really like this mammoth. This is such a good animal. Why are you... Not you. Of course, because you're level bloody 29. That's probably why you've got so much stamina. But still, that's so... Yeah, but see, so and so. This is what I'm talking about. It's level 29, but it still has the same experience need as level 1. So it's going to level up remarkably quickly. Oh, look at that. Just... Oh, here's 150 wood. Oh, my lord, that's awesome. It's got that really slow attack, then. It's got a really fast attack as well. I'm not sure how to do the fast attack. Is there a way to make it do it? Oh, looking down makes it do the fast attack, which harvests faster. Look at... Oh, nope, it's not that. It just does it anyway. How much wood have you got? I think I'm going to have to drop some of it. Okay, let's drop some of the berries. Seriously, that's fantastic. Now all I need is something that can harvest fiber. Then I'll be able to make things like bridges in seconds. There we go, level up. I think your carrying capacity probably needs to be increased, honestly. It's so low. There we go. Not by much, but... I think I'll do that a couple of times, then I'll go back to just doing something else. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, so what I think I'll need to do is bring some pack animals with me. I'll try and tame some of those proto-elephants, the... I normally get... This is not one of the few names I normally get right. The Theomia. I'll try and tame a couple of those soon, and we'll use those as pack animals just to carry the wood with me. Because look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Almost 600 wood just given to me there. That's fantastic. That is absolutely fantastic. I mean, even though we are on currently double resources, that would still be 200 wood. That's loads. Also, give me back my narcotics, buddy. The actual only problem is I'm not getting enough thatch. There we go. I can actually sprint again now. So let's get over here. Move away, tree. Don't make me hurt you. How do I make it do that for quick attack? That's all I don't know. So much faster at harvesting doing that. Come on, tree, fall over. Come on. Fall. You're being hit by a mammoth and sometimes you're not even being harvested for some reason. Okay, so just drop a chunk of wood. Yeah, you know, I'll just drop 100 wood. That's fine. That's no big deal. Oh yeah, forgot I had that little parasaur being tamed. So let's get over here, and we'll see if we can make a bridge across one of the deeper areas of the water. Although it'll make it more difficult on myself, it'll also look way more impressive. So if it works, what we'll be doing is putting pillars down in the middle of the water, attached to whatever it can actually attach to. And then when it comes to the land, ow, smacked in the face, smacked in the butt, by my Bronto, we'll just then move over to ramps to get to the... Oh god, you're about to be unknocked out. Here, just use up the rest of the narcos are in your inventory currently. Nom 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 nom. And that was for me. Okay. So, craftables. The pillar's already there. I haven't got anywhere near enough fiber, so... Yeah, so it's kind of weird now. After all that, now I can't get enough fiber. Is there an animal which can get fiber? I'm not too sure. Okay, anyway, let's just get, let's say, 4 pillars, and we'll see. Are they called pillars or columns? They're called pillars, okay. Then we'll figure out if this even works. Oop. guess if I was holding down E or not. No, I've already called to an accident. I've already double nine precious. I'll call you Whoopsie. Hey, yo, Whoopsie. Why don't you level up then? But you did. I don't. I can't remember reading patch notes about that even being a thing, so I've got to look into that. So yeah, back in a second with the pillars. Well, here comes the testing then. We've got four pillars, and then we also have with us some foundations and ceilings. So again, I don't know what can actually... I've never used pillars before properly, so this is going to be a bit of an experience. So put one here. Going to want it a bit higher than that then, I suppose, unless I can put it straight on. Can it actually go on top? How does it work then? Ah, that's not a good sign. Okay, let's try another one. So, does it go on top? Aha! Ceilings can be put on top. But can foundations? I guess not. Okay, that's fine though. I mean, ceilings are perfect. So, I guess the pillars actually act as foundation then, in all intents and purposes. So, essentially what we're going to do then, is we're going to continue this along. And that is how we're going to have our little bridge, and then again have a little ramp off. Okay, awesome. So let's go and do that. All I actually need is thatch. I've actually got all my wood still, of course, on the mammoth. Now, do I put down the ceiling then the... This is going to get a bit weird. Okay. Well, I'm just going to quickly grab the fiber and make some more pillars. Well, it's almost night time, but I've got everything I need. I've got some ceilings and some more pillars. I'm currently encumbered, and sadly I had to get some more thatch, and that's what took so darn long. Since the mammoth is essentially, I think by the looks of it, it's just attacking the trees as if it had a axe equipped. Probably better than that, actually, so... Ooh, look at this. Okay, so now what do we do? Do we attach this like this? And will that... work. I'm hoping that's the way. Oh, yep, it is. Fantastic. So you just attach it straight to the ceiling piece. Oh, it's night time. That's fine. I can just about see what I'm doing. Just about. Doesn't help if I'm going to bobbing up and down in the water. Must be said. And I probably can't do anything. Oh, okay. So here, then here. I love how it sticks in the ground. It just allows you to do that. That's really nice. Oh, we're yay! I'm on the surface now. Oh god, I can't see a thing. Where's my torch? Let's actually equip a torch, shall we? So we'll see what the hell I'm doing. Ah, that's the problem. After the first one, it attaches really weirdly. I had this problem when I was building the other one. I didn't think it was occurring here, but it is. When you attach the pillar, you have to attach it like that, and it goes through the thing a little bit. Could we perhaps do it the other way around then? No, we couldn't, because that way it'd be too far in the air. Okay, something we have to live with unless there is a way around that. Of course, first time using them. Still freaking awesome though, if I can actually do this. Okay, one more. That didn't quite end up where I wanted it to, honestly. I'd like it more here, but that's fine. Doing it a bit sideways for some reason. Ah. Well, that's not in the thing, is it? Which means I can't... Okay, well, hopefully I can still add a ramp. So I need a couple more pieces, then a ramp. So I'll go and do that very quickly. Then I'll finish the end of it there off camera, because honestly this is taking a bit too long. And good morning. So, this is it. Let's put this here. Oh, wait, that's not attached, is it? So I guess we won't be able to. Okay, so pillar goes in here. Oh, would you look at this? It's not... working properly because of how high it is. Oh dear, oh dear, we've run into a slight snag. Okay, so let's demolish this. Put the pillar down first. Did that actually work? Was it just... Nope. That did not actually attach. Ah, because I put it in the same place again. I thought I'd put it lower. Oh, come on, put... Okay, I'm going to have to delete this and put this on second, aren't I? That's annoying. Okay, demolish you. Oh, too heavy. Currently can't move. Wood, where are you? Go away. Not right now. Thank you. My last 11 fiber. No. Oh, what did I just say? Oh my lord, I'm so bad at this. Okay, pillar goes down first. At least we know where it was because of that. So there. then that'll still not be allowed. I'm guessing we can't. That definitely won't count. This is weird. I guess I could do is have one on the side, perhaps, and try to mount it like that, or perhaps just one. What I could do is have just a double here. Yeah, it's what I'm gonna have to do, isn't it? Just double it up here. Oh wow, can't have it there. Oh, this is really annoying. Okay. Well then, I've got the ramps, but not the ramp here. I'd like it a little bit further on. Look how dark it is for the morning. What gives? So how am I going to do this then? So we can't go there. And we can't even do that. Okay, where did I put my... Okay, craftables can make a wooden wall. Excellent. Okay, then the mammoth, I believe, is... It's either the mammoth or whoopsie is holding my... foundation. There we go. So we use the wooden wall. Yeah, whatever. I was thinking perhaps we could add the foundation to the bottom here, you see, and then kind of move on to it. I still think we can. This is going to be difficult, that's all. Actually, the foundation. Maybe I could put the pillar on the I don't even know if pillars can be put on foundation. I imagine they could. I'm about to find out either way. That's just in the air still, isn't it? It's not actually attached to the foundation. I'm certain it isn't. Oh, it is! It is! Okay, great. So that's how you do it. You just have to have a foundation piece. Oh, brilliant. Thank the Dark Lords. And then that's far enough in that if this doesn't work, I'll just place the ramp. But I think that just worked. Oh, there we go. All our problems are solved. Just need to use a bit of foundation. And then I'll say that's far enough. It's not actually in the water where we'd have to swim. Okay, so ramp, use item. And... we need one more pillar. Okay, then. So, ramp, use ramp. I might need to make this too wide, so it's got, like, space in the middle. These are not actually clear, but it's there for looks. Excellent. Okay, so let's get Angrath. And let's see if we can walk across this little makeshift bridge we've just put down. Which is awesome, by the way. It's so good we can do this now. Why didn't I use... so many things I should have used before. Mammoths for a start, and then the pillars. Come on, Angrath. I'm riding a T-Rex to test the bridge. Oh, yeah, I think we need to make this double wide.
Okay.
Just about able. Like, oh my god, this is going to fall off so easily. Whee! Well, it saves. I don't actually think Angrath has to swim in this river. Yeah, it's not actually deep enough, so that's okay. But in the future, because there are some really, really, really deep rivers down that way, which I've been using to kind of hunt recently with my Bronto and stuff, to level it up. So I would like very much to be able to walk over there easily. But still, awesome, and it also means I could do it. I don't know how high the pillars can go, but I imagine it's infinite. We could actually, oh my lord, Stone Treads. We could have a bridge from our pillar to the pillar over there, and then we could use them both. But that would take a lot of wood. But it would also it would also level me up and the mammoth. It's surprising how little experience you actually get from... I mean, I didn't really harvest much more, because I had actually a spare amount on... Whoopsie here. Because I started to store it in there after the first one. But even so, I mean, like leveled like maybe 10 experience for the full... I don't know. Anyway, Siren Threads, thank you so much for watching. Before I start rambling even more than usual, thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed the episode and are enjoying the series as a whole, then of course, likes, favourite, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly, Siren Threads, most importantly, shows that ARK is a series you wish to see continued in the future. Thank you, and goodbye. Oh, but before you go, Siren Threads, for those who stayed after the outro, I'm going to name my lovely mammoth Ivory, I've decided, because that's a Swedish name for female, and of course indicates, well, look at the damn tusks. So, yeah, thank you for watching again, and goodbye. I told you I would do that.